I'm getting this money, no matter the weather. Stacking this cheese, I'm getting this cheddar. Your bitch love me, I'm getting her wetter. She wanna love me, but I won't let her. You know I keep it a stack. You know I'm getting them racks. You know I'm popping tags. No, we getting big racks, yeah, yeah.
But, bro, like, energy is real. Like, it's alive. Like, it doesn't disappear. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, scientifically, like, I learned it in school a while back. Like, when you die, your energy's there. It's still decomposing. All the stuff, like, there's, like, an aura.
Mm-hmm. I was even, like, this book I read, like, my favorite book about, like, all of that. This girl was saying how, like, they technically could prove life after death, but they would never put funding into it, for one, and two, because, like, the government, like, they exploit off the death, like, you know, like, everything. Like, if you don't do this, you're gonna die. If you don't take these drugs, you're gonna die. Even the death penalty, you know what I mean? Like, all of that. Like, we kind of need that fear of death. Like, you know, because what imagine we actually did prove. I think there's even a movie like that where they did prove death and everybody starts to kill themselves. Because, you know, it's like, if we once actually prove, like, yeah, there is a life after this, then how is the world gonna look? So it's like, they're never gonna put funding into actually proving that, like, yeah, we do survive after death.
My cousin,
it's probably always gonna be.
I don't believe you survive after death. That's
fam, honestly,
surviving after death is spirits, though, is what you're saying.
Your consciousness lives on.
It's your consciousness. It doesn't mean like your body is now, like,
your soul.
Yeah, it's just like,
it doesn't mean you're walking the earth.
It doesn't mean you're walking.
Going to haunt you. That's not what
it means. It just means, it's like the same way you said your niggas are with you. That's surviving death. Yeah, like that's, they're still they know what's guaning. Like, they're just not physical bodies.
Physically, they're like, honestly, like, when my godfather passed away, like, sometimes I can literally hear him and feel him, and like the day after, like, I had a dream, and it's like I could actually see what happened to him. I swear to God, like, it was so trippy what happened to him, like, you know?
Facts.
And, like, I was young, too. I was, like, in probably, like, grade 3, grade 4, and I literally told my mom, like, yo, I think this is what happened to him. And no one knew, but as soon as I said it in long-term investigation, that's actually what happened. I was, like, in grade 3.
And they always say that, like, the younger you are, the closer you are, because you just...
Yeah, I swear, I told... Because he got into a motorcycle accident. But, like, it's like I could actually see exactly how it happened, when it happened and stuff. And I told my mom, and it was insane. Like, it was so accurate that it scared everybody. Everyone thought I was nuts. Like, you know, like,
that's
weird.
So mad. Well,
stuff like that happens.
There's stuff that happened. Like, it's real.
We're so much more than what we are right now. And, like, even our body, because there's been people, too, like, their heart stops. They've died in the hospital. And people have documented this. And, like, so, you know, Shorty's dead. She's been dead for a hot minute, and, like, the surgeon is doing this and that. You hear conversations in the room.
Yeah.
And, like, she was able to hear and see everything that was going on during the times that she was pronounced dead. Even, like, stuff that was happening with her family, she was able to recall. Yeah, upstairs in the room, because she had no body. She was just a spirit. And then, like, when she came back to life, after however long she was dead, she was able to tell them everything. And they're like, what? That's impossible.
How long, though? How long? How much time? Because... technically, like, was she on a ventilator? Like, was she...
No,
she was
dead. But even if, I get what you're saying, but your brain has still activity. But she couldn't tell you what's upstairs. That's what I'm saying. She could tell
you. Yeah, she wasn't there. She was laying down here. How do I know what's going on?
Oh, what's
upstairs? Yeah, and with her family.
It's just like a coma,
fam.
There's a coma, and they say the same thing. Like, a coma, some people, like, they literally just say you're on a really long journey. Trying to find yourself and stuff like that.
This shit is fucking...
My cousin drowned. He drowned before, and... when he drowned, we were like, yo, you know, it was scary. Like, he was literally dead. Like, he was underwater for 10 minutes. He was done. And then when he got back to life, like, you know, man brought him back because, like, a helicopter came and everything. Man, the man said that all he saw, he just said that he just kept dreaming. Like, he was dreaming. He didn't know what happened. Like, it turned black and he didn't know anything.
Yeah.
Have you guys ever heard of past life regression?
No.
What that kind of also proves, like,
professor.
Yeah, I just this because
give her a PhD.
I just this stuff was so like just so means so much to me. Past life regression, though, it's like people who are able to, like, they put you through a hypnosis and they pretty much tell you your past lives. So what Destiny's talking about, reincarnation, the lives you live. What? When I tell you, it is so crazy. I think this was like I don't know. There's this one, like, a really big known one. He's, like, some guy in the States, but it was a story about him, and I think it was his story actually, and, like, he was. Got a past life regression done on him. But anyways, the man, like, told him about his past life, and he was like, they're able to tell you, like, your name and, like, where you lived. They were able to pull that file up, and, like, that boy did live, and he died this year when they said he died, and he lived in, like, this country, and he lived in this house, and, like, the past life regressionist is able to tell you that because it's your spirit telling you. Like, do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and it's very confusing to me, but it's crazy. It's like, how would you know who is this man? Like, you just said, my name is Timothy, da-da-da-da, I lived here. You're able to pull that up, and you did live here, and you did die that way. That's where a lot of your traumas also come from, they say, is your past life. If you're terrified of, like, killer whales, like me, for example, you could have actually died that way, and through a past life regression, they'll tell you, and that's where that wound comes from, but you don't know. You know, yeah, you're thinking, like, it's just because I experienced something in this life, but it's from a past life. We're not even aware of that. Like, maybe there's just, so there's so just many, like crazy maybe I was
wrong
things.
One of my biggest fears being wrongfully convicted.
Yeah, and that could have literally been something.
What? To go sit out?
That's an idiot thing, fam.
I would be in there. I'd either kill myself or I'm in there going nuts.
And some people aren't killing death everybody.
Imagine.
I'm chinging everybody. Like, you say anything wrong to me, I'm...
But you can't... But isn't killing yourself a crazy sin, fam? God doesn't respect that, bro.
So they say.
Idioting. God doesn't respect
that.
So my pops told me, my mom told me, my grandma.
Yeah, but that's how we're raised. But at the same time, like, even from the Bible, like, for one, well, fuck, I don't even want to go down there. But, you know, the books are, they're not literal. None of the books are literal.
Made by a man, you know?
And they were made by a man. So they're not from God. Like, they're
we're not going down this way.
No. It is proven.
Everyone has their own beliefs, though.
Hold on.
I respect everybody's beliefs.
It is proven fact that the Bible has had chapters taken out by acts of former kings because they had certain beliefs that they personally had, and you're the fucking king. We're talking about guys who are literally on the top and can do whatever they want in a time when there's no internet, so there's no cloud, this information isn't stored. It's this book here is the master copy. Yeah, take that out. Or they've taken out books. So
I feel like, we can't speak on, like, I'm not going to speak on beliefs, but, like, these are actual facts. Like, it's not subjective. Like, they actually have been taken out of the
books. And at the same time,
very articulate.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, she's a college
grad. Wow.
But at the same
subjective? I haven't heard that word in so long.
But, yeah.
But it all depends on your belief. That's why, like, when extremists, if you notice, anybody who's ever far one way or far the other way, it's like, for what reason? Like, I get it. You're passionate about what you love, but whoever's far this side, they're so far that side they don't realize that life isn't just this or that. It's there's so much in between.
Yeah, you need to open your mind.
So yeah, that, like, you got you technically, if you're an open-minded person, you have to be open-minded about everything.
I don't lie, I'm at a loss of words, fam.
Even religion, like,
religion can be so problematic. Catholic,
Hindu, like,
everything links.
So what are you guys?
They all link up.
They literally link.
I have my own beliefs.
I used to be atheist, but not anymore.
What are you now?
What made you, like, what gave you the...
Yeah, why are you not atheist no more?
I don't know, because, like, I don't know. I would think about death, like, pretty, pretty often. And, like, I became really obsessed with death at one point. Like, it was just really bad. And then, you know, like, people died and stuff, but I was trying to think about it, you know, try and think about nothingness, like, just black, blank nothing. It's so hard, like, there's always something, there's always that, like, consciousness there, it can't just be nothing. Even when you try to fathom it, it doesn't work. So that just kind of made me really think, like, okay, no, it does make sense that we go on. I don't know exactly how and what happens, but I know that it's something, so that's why I can't tie myself to any religion, because I feel like religion can be, again, very problematic, and it's a book and this and that, but
religion.
But again, it's just for me, religion is just to give you something to believe.
Yeah, there's like
something to hope for.
It's a guide.
Yeah,
it's a guide through life. Think about it this way, because if you look at all the religions,
you guys are trying to zook me.
No, they all link up. All religions link up.
They all try to teach the same thing for the most part. So, well, for one, the Abrahamic religion. So that's Judaism, Catholicism, and Islam.
You have a lot of knowledge, bro.
Appreciate you.
You do.
I like to learn. But those three religions all come from one root religion. They all come from that's why they call it, you can look it up, Abrahamic religions, and it'll say Islam, Judaism, and Christianity. So that, what does that tell you? There's no reason why Jews, Islams, or Christians should be fighting with one another based off of what their book says. Because they all come from the same, and then if you look at the teachings, you shouldn't kill. It's in all the books.
Yeah.
Shouldn't kill, shouldn't lie, shouldn't steal, shouldn't be a piece of shit. Basically, don't be a piece of shit. Let people live their lives, you live yours. Mm-hmm. Now, some people, and then their religion say, well, in the Bible, you're not supposed to have abortions. Understandable, but more, the theme that happens more in the Bible is, you don't judge people for how they live their life. Their life's different than yours. you're from this part of the world.
Is like down there.
But so the thing is, most of the church people are the most judgiest people. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So that's why I don't really rock with them. That's why I don't really go to church.
But that's the thing
like
about sheep.
I feel like then they make religion look bad, though.
Yeah, they
it's
do.
Like, you know, I don't think religion is meant
they
to
discourage
this
you
thing
from going to church.
That's the point, though.
You don't want to go to church.
If there's anything about life, we're never supposed to know what is right and what is wrong. You notice, like, there's always
there such thing.
Yeah, so it's like even the people them that are like weird, they're super. If you're left-handed, you're the devil.
Yeah,
like,
I heard that when I was younger. Still, yeah, like that, if you're left-handed, you're a writer for the devil or some shit.
Bitch, I'm left-handed.
I was like, what the hell?
And what?
Make it make sense. I'm the devil because I write with my left hand, but yet I'm more loving and caring and endearing than you are.
Then you have certain things, man. Like, it's weird. Certain things in certain in certain countries is okay, but in this country, it's wrong. This country, it's right. Over there, like, we all
think
have
about this.
Right and wrong.
Think
it's
about
weird.
all the uncontacted people. So the people on, like, little-ass islands in the middle of nowhere.
Don't know anything.
I come
about
from an island that has a population of 5,000. At the height of it, it's, like, 12, called Munster Small. Never heard of it in your life.
What is it called?
Munster at. Super small in the Caribbean, and that's just one. There's some in Toga. Toga's like a chain of a bunch of. There's a place that's called fucking Diego something something that the U.S. and the U.K. kicked out all their people because they wanted to put a military base there. Diego Santiago, I think, something like. You can look it up.
That's
literally
nuts.
Evicted the people, but that's neither here nor there. There's untapped touched civilizations yet, meaning they've never been interacted with by. Us.
Western society.
And
or
yet
anything.
Somehow they follow the same hierarchy. They kind of have the same thinking. Because at the end of the day, they're people. They might believe in the sun as their god. Or they might believe in something else. But they're believing in something other than what they see. And that's been happening for thousands of years. The
it
Egyptians,
gives comfort.
Everybody. So it's like,
yes, it really is comfort.
Something.
Still.
And like, I feel like the moral of all of it is like, yeah, be a good person. Don't do fucked up shit. Yeah. If you do bad stuff, you're gonna end up somewhere bad. And also, like,
and
we're
if you
all
do bad shit,
God.
Feel bad about it.
Yeah, feel bad about it. Have
karma,
a
still, like, you know,
just
karma.
Like a universal.
You believe in karma?
Everyone, I believe in karma.
I believe in karma still.
Real talk.
You guys believe in
that
karma?
That even is apparently supposed to come from your past lives too. That you're dealing.
I don't know how to balance it. Sometimes, you know, if I do something bad,
like karma. Also can come from your past lives, like they believe that, like, you know, sometimes what you're dealing with in this life, yeah, it's just like it's
they also say it passes
so
on to your children
on your
all that
on your shoulder.
Yeah, literally.
But you can't ask us though, because we're people that just because I don't like I'm not Hindu, like, so
Hinduism.
Reincarnation comes from Hindu, I'm pretty sure it comes from Hinduism predominantly, but it's in and Buddhism, it's in a lot of like, but think about it, it's from Asia, the Asian, so those people believed in a certain way of thinking that transitioned. Egyptians, way back in the day, they believed in a bunch of different gods. Iris.
Even the Egyptians, though, like, look how heavily influenced, like,
now
how important the afterlife was to them. Like, the way they, like, the way they wrap them, like, you know, like,
oh,
everything
revolves
around, like,
they took care of them.
What
the mummies and all
here,
of that. Like,
this is,
No, brother,
like they lived for their afterlife.
You
had to
take out certain organs for certain reasons. You had to... There is like a whole thing.
And yo, that's
and
another thing. In school, that's why they said, yo, your energy's still there. Because after death, your hair and everything's still growing. Your nails, all of that. So that was just to show you, like, yo, your energy's still
and
there, fam.
Your energy is there because as you decompose and you give nutrients to the fertilizer, and then the fertilizer turns into a blade of grass, and that whatever the fuck it is. Now
you grow something.
There's a lot
in
more
that.
Going on.
Who
so
knows?
So
a lot.
Especially the Egyptians, like the way that they even lined the pyramids and the construction of them. There's no way, it's not humanly possible that they were able to do that. They still can't explain it.
Another theory.
Aliens.
That's
they're just so deeply connected to stuff.
But in a way. So you're scared of orcas, right?
Because
I just watched this like crazy
Wait,
thing
about
orca? Orcas.
Killer whales.
It's a killer whale.
Oh.
And their their intelligence level,
whales are demons.
Yeah, but they're very intelligent. And
insane.
They actually think that they speak their own language.
They
and
do.
Because of AI, they're trying to they've taken
you mean, like,
clips and
intelligence?
Yeah, they're trying to take AI to generate to see if they can create what the conversations are. So when they make certain sounds and stuff and then make certain actions, they input it, then the AI can think. So hopefully one day we'll be able to speak to because killer whales, the way they hunt, they communicate.
Yo, it's
in packs.
Mad.
It's nuts.
If you see a killer whale on the boat, just pray, fam.
No, I've seen them when I lived in BC.
No, like if it wants you, fam, you're a pack.
Oh, well, yeah. First of all, you're in water.
You're a
pack. Done. You're a land animal. Shut up.
The way they deal with you is rude, though, fam.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
They'll rip you apart, bite you.
Like, they'll throw your boat to one side. The next one will
They'll play with you, though.
Yeah.
Like, they like playing with you.
You guys are getting her at that. You guys are saying she doesn't. She's scared of them, bro.
Yeah, but at the same time, they're not like. They want to eat what they eat.
I don't know, man.
Yeah, they're just terrified. I can't look at them.
You think they're marked?
They're they just scare me. Like, they're so scary looking. Their tongues,
where they can
teeth.
Differentiate different kinds of foods.
So scary.
Like, they can tell what kind of fish.
I don't know why my mom ever brought me
like
to
by their sonar.
So, if
it's crazy.
Going to an aquarium for you is off the list.
I went to Ripley's. Like, that's okay.
Is it valid in there or is it a waste of time?
You'd be scared to, like, see a killer
time.
Whale?
Yeah, I think it's a waste of time, yeah. It's like one of those things, like, maybe you could go to say you went, you know? But it's not, like, anything.
It ain't shit in there.
I like the playground.
They ain't got no real.
I hear that.
No, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's something in there? Playground?
Yeah. Oh. It's for the kids, but I mean, you could still
go. If you went somewhere and you saw a killer whale, but it's behind glass.
No,
like,
no way.
Not
even Google.
Even if you, like, send her images, she'll scream and throw her phone.
I'm dashing my phone, like, nothing. Yeah, regrets.
That scarred her.
Scarred me.
Yo, in Jamaica, there's a place where you can ride the dolphins.
Yeah, maybe one did deal with you in your past life.
Yeah, I swear they had to. It's maybe mine. I was like
Bro,
a seal.
Maybe you
that's what I'm thinking. Or a seal.
You do kind of look like a seal, you know.
Yeah, you are, bro.
No.
Oh, that's another thing. That's, like, do you believe that people were animals or they look like certain animals?
Or fish.
Yeah, then that's why I'm scared of killer whales.
No, we're saying, like, maybe she was killed by one of the past life, or maybe she was a seal or a herring.
Because they say that people look like creatures. Everyone looks like a certain animal.
So I had a past life.
We don't know.
Yeah,
we don't know.
You just don't remember.
I don't believe in reincarnation,
honestly,
believe in it.
At the end of the day, bro, it's like literally what you believe in and what you over, you know? But
What are you guys going to do if we go into war?
Do you guys
see what's happening in the world in terms of food prices?
No, it's getting really scary. If I'm not rich, I think it's so unethical to have children because they're going to be fighting for water.
Fighting for water is insane, but fuck, bro. I guess that really concludes our thing on energy and spirituality, all of that. Before he goes on to another topic,
yeah, literally.
You know what I'm saying?